Good morning, everyone. It is Thursday, day four of a it was a 6-day work week, but now it's a 5-day work week. We closed Saturday for fuel. So I talked to my brother Wes the other day, and he told me something that was very interesting and alarming and disheartening all at the same time, honestly. My nephew's there, and I'll put the coach on blast. I don't care. My nephew Xander, he wrestles for Brink Jr. This is his last year there at Brink, and then he'll be going to Westmore next year. And Xander's been wrestling for Brink for the last 2 years, I believe. 2 or 3 years. And he's getting better from what Wes has told me. So the story of the story goes like this, and this is, and I actually wish it was a story and not real fact, real life story. So the wrestling team that Xander wrestles for has a duel this Saturday at either Sepulpa or Sulphur, one of the two. I'm not exactly sure offhand, but it's one of those two. So their head coach for Brink Junior High basically told the kids that he's not going, that if they want to go, they'll need to provide their own transportation and pay their own entry fee to get into this tournament. This tournament is on their wrestling schedule. You know, preseason tournaments, that's one thing. You know, you're not scheduled. You know, you don't have to be there for the preseason tournaments. It just helps you get better and get ready. So when I wrestled in high school, and this goes for my brother, you know, our coach, Gordon Mercer, and coach and assistant coach John Lee, as well as assistant coach Griffith. You know, they were at the duels, they were at tournaments, and in our corner. They did their job. I'll be ever grateful for what they taught me when I wrestled in high school. You know, as well as teach me lessons, you know, teach me what I was in school. Uh, this coach a break. I don't know why he's not going. I don't know why any of the assistants aren't going. You know, I feel that if this coach, teacher, whatever he wants to be called, if he took the job being the coach, being the wrestling coach, he should have known that he will have to give up some of his weekends. My question would be this. Okay, let's say he has guys that go to state, that wrestle in the state. Is he going to take them to state, or is he just be like, you guys just got to go on your own and pay your own entry fee to get into the state wrestling tournament? That's some bull. I haven't. Oh. So, my mom, the nice, kind, wonderful woman that she is going to call the high school and talk to their wrestling coach. Well, I tell my brother, I go, look, bro, if mom doesn't find anything out by talking to your wrestling coach, call the school board. Not Brink, not Westmore, call more public school board. Find out why or something on why this coach is not wanting to take his team or his athletes to a tournament that he said he would be there. That's kind of... Once I find something out, I will let everybody know what happens. But the neat thing about it is this, is that my twin brother Wes, he said while we were talking and everything, if Xander does wind up going to this tournament, my brother's gonna go with and be in Xander's corner, be on, help coach Xander. And Wes told me, he goes, Xander tells me that, hey, there's some of his teammates, and then the coaches are there, my brother's going to be in those guys' corner. So, it's one of those things is that, all right, well, if you don't want to do this, then I'll step up and take care of it. And another thing that's bad is that my mom gave this coach all of Wes's information to contact him for whatever. And this coach has not contacted him at all. You would think that having a parent that wants to be a part of whatever their child is doing, said teacher or coach would get in touch with the parent. At least I know that's been the case for us here in UConn. We tell the teachers, hey, if you have any issues or need anything, give us a call. Shoot us an email. Whatever. As you can tell, excuse me, I am slightly upset over this. I really hope they find out what's going on and get it remedied. So, but like I mentioned, I will let you guys know what's going on and let you know the end result. And if Xander does go this week, Thursday to replace the lunch, you guys know. So, with that all being said, I do appreciate, you know, I kind of like doing this because I'm able to get things off my chest. I'm able to talk about things, you know, about, oh, well, because of this or because of that, or, hey, this is going on, or, hey, that's going on. It gives me a opportunity to vent out, talk, and everything. And, you know, whoever wants to give feedback, please give feedback. I am not one to shy from criticism or whatever. So if y'all want to comment, if you say, hey, enjoying them, hey, do this, hey, do that, or, you know, you just need to shut up, not do anymore, you know, post what you want, you know. I would greatly enjoy reading at all comments. So, with that being said, ladies and germs, I do appreciate you guys watching, and, I hope you all have a great day, and I will talk to you soon. I will talk to you sometime, more than likely tomorrow morning, on my way out for day number 5. So, you guys have a great day, and, be blessed. Later, guys.